In our last lecture, we learned how to connect to database and also create a table in database using PHP MyAdmin. In this lecture, I'm going to show you how to connect to the database from PHP using PDO, PHP Data Object, which is one of the available API for connecting to MySQL database with PHP. So it's very simple. It's not complicated. Let's go over to the resource folder and open the database file, database.php. In order to connect to MySQL database with PDO, we need to create a new instance of the PDO class and specify the DSN, which is simply the data source name. We specify the database username and also the database password. So let me show you an example. So for instance, I'll say db equals new PDO. So first option, as you can see here, my test editor is showing me that I need to specify the DSN, data source name. This basically will tell PDO the driver that you want to use, because with PDO, we can actually use about 12 drivers. So for these, we're going to be using MySQL. So specify my drivers, MySQL. So MySQL, then we need to specify the host name as part of the DSN string. Host is going to be equal to localhost. Then we also need to specify the database name. So remember our database register. So next we need to specify the username, which is our database username. So specify this as root. Then we also need to specify the password. For me, it's just empty string. With this, we've already created or established a connection to MySQL database, as simple as this is. So here, like I've said, we specify the data source name, which consists of the driver that we're using and the connection string. For instance, here we're using MySQL driver and the host is localhost, while the database name is register, then followed by the username and the password. Okay, so next we just test to see if this connection is successful. We just echo connected to the register database. Okay. All right, so we'll go over to our index file and include the database.php file so that we can access it. Okay, so include once, specify the folder source, okay, source/database.php. So now go over to the browser, localhost/auth error, uncaught exception, PDO with message, could not find driver. So this basically shows us that there was a problem while we are attempting to connect into the database, and the problem is the driver could not be found. So let's go over to our test editor, open the database.php file. Then we see here that I actually mistakenly type MySQL. So supposed to be MySQL. So correct this, save and refresh the browser and connect it to the register database. So we've successfully connected to the database, but this is not a better way to set up things. A better would be for us to specify our parameters into variables so that we can in turn just include the variables into the PDO constructor. So let me show you how to do that. We'll create variables. First will be username. So in this case, root. Next we create another variable DSN. And we just pick up the string from here and paste it here. Next, we need to specify password. Password in my case is empty string. So we could just put here DSN. DSN, then username and password. So looks a lot cleaner to me. Password. Okay, next, like we saw just now when I mistakenly typed something here, go back to the browser and illustrate that again. So you see the exception being displayed. This is the default way in which PDO is set up to handle exception. By default, it is set up to be in error mode silent, which means we manually need to fetch exception by ourselves. And this will also expose a lot to people who are using our application. So we don't want to display our error messages like this. Instead, we should use the PDO exception class to undo errors that may occur while attempting to make a connection to the database. Okay, let me show you how we can do that. So we're going to wrap this up within a try catch block. So I just take this out, try, then catch. So we're going to be catching an exception, and the exception we want to catch here is PDO exception. I'll call this ES. Okay, so then we'll come back to the try block. So basically what we're doing here, we're going to try to make a connection to the database. If it is successful, we display this. If it is not successful, we could just display a simple string, echo connection failed. Okay, so echo connection failed. I will go over to the browser and refresh. So instead of that error message that we've seen previously, we just display this to our user. Connection failed. But when we are developing, then we can actually assess the actual message that is being displayed. ES get message. So if we go over to the browser again and refresh, it tells us could not find driver, which is a much cleaner way to display error message. All right, get rid of these. The error mode for PDO by default is set to error mode silent. So we might need to set it to exception. So say DB set attributes. Attribute we want to set will be attribute error mode. So we'll call this PDO scope resolution. So attribute error mode. We want to set this attribute to PDO exception. Okay. PDO error mode exception. Okay, so let's try this out again. Refresh gives us more detailed information. Access denied for user, local host as database register. So we go over and see why is access denied for user, local host at register. See, there's another error. So what's that? Oh, you see here, I didn't forgot to put the T. So specify here root. And we'll refresh again. So connected to the register database. So basically, this is a much cleaner way to establish a connection to database using PDO, PHP data objects.